The next question from Francis Pabular. Naku, Francis, ayokong sagutin to, Francis. Pero sasagutin ko. Hi! A lot of people were requesting in my Facebook, messaging me and my Instagram asking if I could do a Q&A. So may mga tanong na medyo hirap sagutin. Meron naman na, you know, just mga regular questions, hindi sobrang personal. Pero I'll be answering some now, of course. So for Carmen Diaz, first question. What are your plans after your political career in Tacloban? Alam naman ng mga tiga Tacloban, and for those who are not from Tacloban, I've been in politics or well in government service for 12 years. 9 years as councillor, that's 3 terms, and 1 term as mayor in local government. Medyo mahaba-haba yun. So ngayon, I really feel that God is putting me back with my children in Manila. More in Manila than in Tacloban, of course. I will still go and visit, syempre. Pero talagang, I really feel that God has some new things for me. Maybe to go back and take care of our existing businesses. I think you know of one, Patio Victoria, si Intramuros, di ba? Yung mga weddings and events venue. That's one. And I need to rest. I need to rest. After 12 years of in politics in Tacloban, it's not a joke. Lalo pang naabutan kami ng Yolanda. Yung Yolanda, napakatinding problema, pinakamalakas na bagyo nga daw sa buong mundo, sabi nila. So that's what me and my children went through 2013. And so since that time, yung mga bata umuwi na ng Manila, nag-aral dito. So I really believe that they need, of course, yung pag-aaruga ng isang ina. Siyempre, pamilya muna. Kasi kung hindi ko maalagaan ang pamilya ko, paano ko ba maaalagaan ang mga constituents ko? So kailangan ayusin ko muna yung pagiging ina. And I think 12 years is long enough. No, medyo mahaba-haba na yan. Okay, and for the next question, from Marisa Dumale. Marisa, ilan na po anak ninyo? Well, yes, I have 2 children. My eldest, she's 19 already. This year, she's... I can't believe she's gonna be turning 20 this year, Sophia. And mahilig siyang kumanta, mahilig siyang mag-compose, at nag-play din ng mga iba-ibang instruments, piano, guitar, lahat. And yung isang anak ko, who just turned 16 this year, sobrang hilig din sa music. May mga banda siya sa school. Drummer siya, actually. Very good drummer. For me, syempre, anak ko. Pero talagang magaling siya. Sa bahay, may studio na kami here at home in Manila. Because of my 2 kids who just love music. And they get too loud sometimes. Yung nagre-reklamo yung mga neighbors namin. And the next question from Francis Pabular. Naku, Francis, ayokong sagutin to, Francis! Pero, sasagutin ko. Ilan taon na kayo? Ilan taon na ako? Ilan taon sa tingin mo? Francis, I'm 50 already. So, ganun ang buhay. So, but I'm happy. So, another question from Shan Shandy Guzman. What is the most embarrassing moment you will never forget? Okay. Shan Shan, yes. Actually, marami akong na-encounter ng mga embarrassing moments throughout my life. You know, I guess we all have. But one of the most embarrassing that sticks to my mind and I can't forget is nung... I can't remember kung mga 18 or 19 ako noon. And syempre, at that age may mga crush-crush tayo, di ba? You know, cute guys and all that. But anyway, at that time, may crush ako. And yung isang friend ko, BFF ko, ay nako, she told the guy na may crush ako. So since that time, parang sobra akong embarrassed. Kasi we're in one group eh, barkada, friends kami. Sobra akong hiyang-hiya. Ayoko nang, I don't wanna face the guy actually. I didn't wanna face him anymore or be with him anymore. I was so embarrassed. Yun, pinaka-embarrassing, kakahiya, nabisto ka ng crush mo. Oh, from Prisette. Hi, Prisette! From Quizette 2. What was the hardest challenge you encountered as mayor and how did you move past it? Another question from Quizette. Would you willingly do politics again? The hardest thing I've encountered as mayor. Well, I've encountered a lot of hard things. you know, bilang councilor and lalo pa rin bilang mayor sa local government. So, marami. Pero ang isang siguro pinaka-challenging, kasi marami pa rin talaga mga walang disiplina o matitigas sa ulo. We were trying to really, of course, we tried to keep the city clean hanggang ngayon, but meron pa rin mga areas or barangays na talagang matitigas ang ulo at talagang kung saan saan tinatapo ng basura, hindi doon sa kanilang mga designated area na kung saan dapat itapon. We had to put people watching station on those certain problem areas, problem barangays, para bantayin lang sila at baka magtapon. At pag nawawala yung mga nagbabantay, nagtatapon na naman sila. But anyway, it's for now, it's solved already. So if we devise a system na kahit wala yung nagbabantay, may mga fines naman na tayo for that. But that's one of the most challenging, keeping the city clean. From Albert Mules. Hi Albert, I know you from Tacloban. The question ni Albert is, do you have any fave TV series? Albert, yes, I have, but it's really, really old. I don't know if you guys watch it. It's been there from way back. It's called Friends. So they still have it, of course, on Netflix and all that. I watch the replays. It just makes me laugh. I love stuff that just makes me smile and laugh. Na sobrang light. Hindi nang gusto kong comedy na sobrang light na makes me happy. So Friends, yes. And then from Joanna Almodovar. From Joanna Almodovar. Nice name. What is your favorite food? Favorite food. What is my favorite food? Actually, Joanna, I don't want to say this, but I don't know if you're like me. Yung totoong mga favorite food ko, yung mga masasamang pagkain. Diba? Kung ano yung masasama kainin, yun ang masarap. So that's really all the bad food, from pizza to burgers. That's really my favorite thing. I could eat it every day. Bad chips, you know, salty stuff. But it's right now, of course, I'm trying to eat better food, gluten-free. Ako ngayon, I'm trying. Although I cheat once in a while, I try to lessen my carbs, eat more fruit, eat more vegetables. But then again, sabi ko, of course, I also love all Asian food. I love Peking duck. Kahit anong Peking duck, maubos ko isang duck kung Peking duck yan. But yun, all the bad food that I have. And then, from Hillmark. Nako, Hillmark ha. Ayoko ng ganyan ng Hillmark ha. Anyway, actually, I saw these questions in my FB and sabi ko, sasagutin ko ba itong mga ganito, mga, you know, how, syempre, mga chika-chika, mga chismes. Ang tanong ni Hillmark, totoo ba nahiwalay na kayo ng asawa niyo? Ha, 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 ha. Okay, sasagutin kita. Hiwalay kami ng bahay dahil mayor ako. So, Tacloban ako most of the time. And Manila siya most of the time kasi hindi siya mayor. So, yun ang sagot ko. Ha, 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 ha! I hope you enjoyed this Q&A video. And remember to, of course, click like and click subscribe. And have a blessed day. Remember to make God first. Every day, don't forget him. He loves you so much. And of course, I like to always pray and say, God bless all of you. God bless your families. And take care. Till the next video, coming soon.